According to the organization, 600 to 800,000 people are visiting King's Day every year in Amsterdam. Trying to imagine 600 to 800,000 people. What does it mean if you have 800,000 people coming to Amsterdam? You need 3,000 extra policemen. You need 4 to 5,000 public toilets. And if everybody's going by train, I'm trying to imagine you need 600 trains to Amsterdam and 600 days from Amsterdam, the longest trains of Holland, in one day. Or if everybody's going by car, you need to park 200,000 to 300,000 cars in Amsterdam. Trying to imagine that. So you need to have an accurate number. And not only because of logistics and because of safety, but also because of economics. Does it make sense to give subsidy to an event? And since last week, the inauguration of Trump is also clear that you need to have an accurate number only because of politics. And 8 years ago, we only had counting cameras. They were quite, let's say, accurate, but for such an event, it is impossible. And also, it took sometimes a very long time to get permission to get a counting camera somewhere installed. In one case, it took me over a year, which was very, very frustrating to me. And on a Friday afternoon, and it was really Friday afternoon, we came to the idea to use mobile telephones. And just a question to the audience, who does not have a mobile telephone in his possession? Everybody has a mobile telephone, and we're using it all the time. We're using it for business. We are using it for leisure. We are using it in a train. That can be very annoying, as everybody knows. Or we're using it in a car. Be careful, that can be very dangerous. And we're using it 100 times a day. For texting, make a telephone call, Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever. 100 times a day, and every time it connects with an antenna, we can count the number of phones. We can count the number of phones in a certain area. But 8 years ago, it was just an idea. And as I told you, as was already told, I'm a chemical engineer, and I have not in-depth knowledge about big data. But I talked with a lot of potential customers. And it became clear that this kind of information was very valuable for them. So together with a big data specialist, we start to build a team and we start to make a plan. And the first thing, of course, we have to have the raw data coming from a telecom operator. They were interested in this idea, but they were very, very keen about privacy. So we added a very experienced privacy lawyer to our team, and we started to build a system to ensure privacy. And we convinced them to start working with us. And which was, by the way, quite special, because that was a big multinational working together with a very small company. And I think our experience and also our age, the whole team was around 50 years old, helped a lot. And sometimes it's nice to be a little bit older. Today we have around 415 million data points per day. But then you have big data. But you want to have information. And coming from big information to data, software and algorithms to go to information. And what can you do with this kind of big data? Or I must say, what can you do with this kind of information? Let's go back to King's Day. We measure through the whole of the Netherlands. So we can see that on King's Day, Amsterdam and Eindhoven are the two places to be if you want to have a party. But not for these two persons. What happened? They are dressed for the party, as you can see. They were in the right place, but they were on the wrong time. Here you see the Americans, and everybody knows King's Day is on April the 27th, but we used to have Queen's Day on April the 30th. And you see there is a peak of Americans on King's Day, but you see also there's a peak of Americans on April the 30th. And just a free advice for all the Americans Just buy a new traveling guide if you don't want to miss the party. Tourism is quite important for the Netherlands. 68 billion euros, 600,000 people working in this area. And the Americans are only going to Amsterdam. And it is the goal of the Dutch government to spread tourism, that they not only go to Amsterdam, but also to other beautiful cities in the Netherlands. And with big data or big information coming from your telephone, we can see if they are successful. For our neighbors, it looks different. Of course, they like to go to Amsterdam, but for sure they like to go to Venlo and Roermond, nearby Sittard, where we are here today, doing shopping. And they like to go to the beach. And if everybody knows, we like to build sandcastles, and the Germans like to dig holes. And when I was preparing this TED talk, I found out that this has a history back from 1877. It all started with the design of the first German beach chair. But I think this is another subject for another TED talk, but interesting to know. We measure how many people go from one place to the other. For instance, from Stein to Geleen, 3,000 trips every day. With the bus, including walking, it costs you around 40 minutes, and by car, it costs you 10 minutes. And is it worthwhile to improve public transport? That's not for us to decide. That's between the public transport company and the local government. But at least they can start a discussion based on facts. That there are 3,000 people traveling, traveling from Stein to Geleen, and not having discussion based on, let's say, feelings or opinions. Another example is coming from Amsterdam Arena. Coldplay was playing last year for 2 days. And the first day, we measured that 24% of the people went by train. And it was a complete traffic jam. The A2 was blocked completely. People left their cars and walked to the arena to be on time at Coldplay. That went viral. It was all over the news. And the next day, 31% of the people went by train and there was no traffic jam. And in my opinion, this was the most effective PR campaign for the Dutch railroads I have seen. But I think, and I also hope, that this was not their idea. In Holland, we spent 600 million euros to reduce the traveling time with 10%. It's called beter benutten. And we can now measure with this telephone data if they are successful or not, and if this beter benutten campaign is effective. As you know, today we are in the beautiful city of Sittard. And we know on average 400,000 people are visiting Sittard Center every month. And the highlight is in October, and people from here, they know that in October we have the Oktoberfest. But also December with the Winter Dream and with Christmas shopping, you see that there are 450,000 people visiting Sittard Center, with December the 17th as the highlight. This kind of information is important for city marketing, especially if they can compare it with other cities, but also for the retailers. And Sittard Geleen is also using to measure events, so they can rank the events to reallocate their subsidies. The potential of big data is huge, and what I showed you today is nothing more than a glimpse of what is possible. But if we look a little bit to the future, we are now measuring the past. But with predictive analysis, we are going to predict the future behavior of mobility of people. We are going to real-time data, especially for traffic management. But for me, the most exciting thing is that we can use it worldwide. We can use it in Europe, we can use it in Washington, they need it, and we can, but we can also use it in Africa, because everybody has a mobile telephone and they are using it. And where are the people located? Where are they going to? How do they travel? Important to understand daily life, but also important when there is, for instance, a natural disaster. But for me personally, has it brought me what I anticipated? 8 years ago? First of all, the answer is yes and no. It cost me much more time and money than anticipated. And I've set up over 10 startups, and it's almost always the case, especially when you have a new technology in a new market. And we had many successes, but to be honest, we also encountered drawbacks and problems to be solved. But if you want to have a successful innovation, or if you want to have a successful innovation, and that can be technical innovation, but also social innovation within your organization or as an entrepreneur, you need to have a good idea, yes. You need to have a good idea, but perseverance and having the right team, I think it's even more important. But for me, the most rewarding thing after 8 years is that I can say, I love it when a plan comes together. Thank you.